Hey guys, welcome to GiantKiller.co. My name is Daniel Frank, and we'll be looking at George Mason's 73-55 victory over the American Eagles tonight. First things first, we got to talk about that second half. That was by far this group's best second half of the best half of the season. They outscored American 43-26 in the second half. They didn't have a bad start. The first quarter, they outscored American 17-12. Second quarter was not great. Again, this continues to be a little bit of their kryptonite so far this season, something they got to work on. They let American get back in the game. They couldn't really create much separation in the first quarter. They ended up giving up the lead at one point. Nicole went out with her second foul, and American made their run. Nicole came back in right before halftime and hit a three, and the Patriots took a one-point lead to halftime. You can kind of feel things took a turn for the better. The one bad thing that did happen as well in the first half is Cameron Gatling went out with an injury. It appeared to be a bit of an ankle injury. Coach didn't give any update in the presser. We didn't expect her to, let's be honest. But we did see her after the game, both on crutches and in a boot on her one foot. So we certainly wish Camry the best, and we hope to see her back soon. But second half, George Mason came lights out. To start the second half, they had a nice 5-0 run. I'm sitting right behind the visiting bench, and I'll just give y'all a little secret in that that first timeout that their coach called, she was not too pleased and slammed the clipboard down and just yelled at her players, "I hate when you guys do this." So certainly George Mason was causing some frustration. We asked Nicole about that post game. This is what she
had to say. Nicole, the first half for you wasn't the best for you. Second half is obviously a very different story. You had 17 points in the second half. How much did you feed off of, did you feed off of any frustration that you saw from American? Because it seemed like from where I was sitting that the more things started to not go right for them, they got a little frustrated. How does that motivate you, or does it affect you at all?
I think that we definitely got better on defense, and we as a team feed off of that. And so I definitely feed off of that too. And I mean, my teammates were just getting the ball where I needed it. You know, they were sealing when I needed it. So I mean, it's just the whole team dynamic.
Yeah, a pretty good seal one time.
Right. Yeah, the whole team dynamic definitely just helps you get in the whole rhythm of the game.
And I thought in the second half there was one play, I think I'll know what I'm talking about, when J.C. Dovin saved the ball, and the ball went basically right to you. Mm-hmm. That seemed like kind of the dagger in the game. How much does that say about like this team and the togetherness of this team? And then when Liv hit the shot, I saw y'all jumped up in the air. That was great to see.
We just feed off of each other, and when one gets going, we all get going, and I feel like we just feed off of each other, and so when things go right, and on defense and then offense, it's just great.
We're a very together team. I mean, I hope that's obvious on the floor. We don't really care. We need some key people to score, and obviously Nikki's one of them, but we really don't care. We just want to score the basketball. I thought we were really, really, really good out of timeouts tonight, and really executing what we needed to. And, you know, one of our big things we're really focused on is trying to see how many stops we can get, or vice versa. And I think when we go back and look, particularly the second half, I think we strung some pretty good possessions together.
So again, as we were saying, by far that was Mason's best half of the season. Sorry, we had to move there. They're packing up EBA here. I guess they're all getting ready for tomorrow night at Maryland. But anyway, so we're shooting the selfie style now. But just real quick, that was by far their best second half, or their best half of the season. They really showed a lot of togetherness. There was one play that happened right in front of me where JC dove and saved a ball. And then the ball went right to Nicole. She hit the layup. And that really, you felt the momentum moving at that point. There was a lot of frustration from the American bench after that shot. You could kind of tell the game was getting away from them. So really a great game from Mason, especially in the second half. A lot of really great things, I thought, in that half. In particular, Nicole only had 6 points, and she had a couple turnovers in the first half. She came out and had 17 in the second half. She finished at 23. In her best performance of the season, arguably. JC and Alexis Grace both had 10 as well. Just a really good team win. I thought Alan McCool came in off the bench and had some really nice defensive plays, and as well setting screens and helping Nicole get open and getting her some good looks. So that'll pretty much do it from this one. They're packing up BBA. We got to get out of here. We will be back here for Mason's next home game. I believe it's Tuesday night. And as well, we'll be going up to Maryland tomorrow night. Friday night for the big men's game. So make sure you guys stay tuned to GiantKiller.co for some more coverage of this game, as well as more Mason coverage. And thank you guys for watching. See you all next time.